mailbox of the person you are calling is currently full and cannot accept new messages. Please try your call again later. Thank you.
Hello, and thank you for calling the Forest Fair Village Mall. Our office hours are Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. For the office management, press 1. For the main office, press 2. If this is an emergency, please call our mall security. Ashley
is not available to take your call.
Hi, Ashley. This is David Dreyer. I'm a Wyoming high school senior and I'm in a documentary film class. And we're doing a bit on the mall and we wanted to clear it with some sort of mall management about filming. We didn't want to go in there and just start filming without any sort of permission. So if you could call me back, I'd really appreciate it if I could talk to you, and I hope you're having a great day. Bye.
We asked management in person if we could, in fact, film. We got a firm no. He said we'd be escorted out if they did catch us filming.
The key word there is if he caught us. Problem is, they never did.
So, we went ahead and filmed anyway. Granted, a lot of the footage is a little unconventional compared to what we thought we were going to get. But the show has to go on, doesn't it? What we now refer to as Ghost Mall was constructed in 1989 by the Australian real estate franchise LJ Hooker.
The mall cost $250 million to be constructed, $50 million over budget.
Since its construction, ownership of the mall has passed between several real estate companies.
The most recent purchase of the mall was for around $4 million.
The mall has had several names. It started as Forest Fair Mall, then became Cincinnati Mills, then Cincinnati Mall, and is now officially known as Forest Fair Village. However, none of the signs have been changed since its days as Cincinnati Mall.
The first business we interviewed happened to be right across from mall management, so the only interview that we got was audio.
I'm Jenny Hubbard, and this is my bakery, the Almond Sisters Bakery. It's a handmade artisan bakery, so I do everything from scratch. Everything is an original recipe. I do artisan breads, pastries, muffins, cookies. I moved in May of this year, and I signed a year lease. It's been a really interesting experience.
My name is Emily Schaefer, and I'm the manager at The Screens at Cincinnati Mall. We're a second-run movie theater. We play the movies that we get, we generally get after they drop below the top 20 in the box office. So when they stop making money at the big theaters, we'll get them. Our tickets are $3, $1.75 on Tuesday. I came here in 2006 to run the theater for Danbury Cinemas. September 14th, Danbury closed. I called the owner who eventually took it over and turned it into The Screens to see if he had any positions at his Columbus theater, explain, you know, what happened to Danbury, and he wanted to take over the lease. And it's kind of like a too good to be true type thing, because I love this place. I love my job. I love working here. I love my kids.
Jesse Baker, Arcade Legacy. All you can play game room, video games, just about every kind of video games, arcades, consoles, ping pong, pinball machines. And then you pay one price, play all you want. It's been almost 3 years, getting close to 3 years.
What was the mall like when you first started working here?
Full of stores, busier. It was a much better place. And then about 2009, stores started to leave, and it's gone downhill from there. It's like they can't keep anybody in here. I don't understand why. It's a pretty mall. It's beautiful.
They had plans to put in a big sports arena, and that was gonna be like the big push to get it back to where it was, but after a while that fell through, and really not much has happened since then.
What do you notice about the mall?
just how desolate it is. I'm not creeped out by it. Some people come in here and they're very creeped out, but I don't know, maybe it's just because I'm here all the time. It doesn't creep me out, but the people who are mainly here are mall walkers in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
And
those people that just power walk to get some exercise.
Yeah. I get people come in every day, what happened to this place? And I mean, I remember when this place was, I guess, built or something. I remember being here when it was popular, and it was really cool, but never thought I would ever open a business in here, ever.
There's only a few businesses. There's maybe five or six inside, and then a few anchor stores outside, so it's over 200 empty stores.
I feel like it's just a tax write-off for the owner. Mm. He owns a lot of malls, and this is the lowest in the totem pole, I guess, and he's just, I shouldn't say anymore. But I just, you know, don't think that they care that much. And also, as the weather gets worse, more things, there's more problems with heating and electric and just fire codes. The Forest Park, the Sea of Forest Park, is just finding more and more problems.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just going to cost more and more to fix.
Right.
Who's got the money to do that?
Do you have any thoughts as to why the mall started losing businesses?
I think when they put in all the high-end stores, when Simon bought it and took out Time Out and took out all the family-oriented things, because, I mean, I hung out here in high school and this place was always busy. The theaters were busy. Like, I don't understand why they took out all the family-oriented things and then put high-end stores in, which I feel like chased a lot of our patrons away.
Problem is, you can't put nice stores in Forest Park because the money's not in Forest Park. It's like, you know, the manager, he would love to see more small businesses do this, but it's not his fault. Like,
yeah.
The city makes it difficult. There's a lot of hoops to jump through and lots of problems here that have to be fixed before people can come in.
Well, it's failed, I think, three or four times already, so I think there's just a bad reputation for the mall. The last time that it failed, the company who owned it took all the businesses with them to their new venture, which was the Monroe Outlets, and then everyone else basically just left that didn't want to go there. And so now it's, I think people are just scared to put businesses in here because it's always failed.
What's business like in the mall?
I have a lot of freedom, so much freedom. Because at Tri-County, if you aren't in your spot at a certain time, or if you take a break and you're not back at a certain time, you get fined. Here, I've got way more liberty. I don't do well here at all. I do better with my catering orders. If I was selling, I don't know what else, clothes or, I don't know how I would do.
We have no patrons anymore. There's just a lot more of, I guess, there's a lot more of me actually having to go out and get people to get in here, as far as like going to the hotels, giving them show schedules, you know, going and hanging up signs at McDonald's that we're still here. The mall may be dead, but we're still here. So, but it's difficult. During the week, it's so quiet, it's ridiculous.
Well, I don't even feel like I'm in the mall most of the time. It's because we do good business, so. But my kind of place wouldn't matter so much where it is, because people will come, you know, just because of the kind of place it is. It's more of a destination. So it doesn't feel like we're in a dead mall with no people, because there's usually people.
What do you think the future of the mall is going to be ultimately? Like, what do you think is going to happen to it in the end?
I think it might shut down when Bass Pro leaves, and a lot of the bigger places are getting, you know, have plans to leave.
Like the negative extreme, it closing down and just demolishing it, making it a parking garage or something. I don't know, putting up a hotel or something here.
Yeah.
So. It's sad when you think about it that way, because I hope it goes the other way.
I don't know. I hope it stays open, because then I can stay open. I haven't heard anything one way or the other. I don't see why they would close it all of a sudden. You know, they've had it this way for years. I would think maybe he'll eventually just sell it off to somebody else who thinks that they can do some magic and revive it. maybe somebody who has a good idea, or I don't know, they had a good plan, it just didn't work out, unfortunately.
I really hope, well, there it's up for sale again. I don't know if you guys know that.
These Chinese guys have been scoping out the place for over a month now. They have lots of partners and they want to do, they want to make it more of an entertainment district, which I think would be way more. The mall itself, the scene of a mall, just isn't like happening as much. And if this was more of a place where you can do sports and or have like clubs and stuff, that's what these Chinese guys, they want to do. But I haven't seen them in a while, so I haven't seen them in like a month and a half, so I don't really know.
I'm hoping somebody buys it and puts all the family-oriented stuff back in here and just kind of makes it like a family, you know, entertainment complex. Like, put the Ferris wheel back in, put Putt-Putt back in, you know, all the fun stuff. The arcade's already there. We got the movie theater, so, you know, I think that would do it justice and bring everybody back.
So, you know, if they shut down or get torn down, what do you think's gonna happen to like your business because of that?
My whole goal in the first place is to move into Art Space, which is downtown Hamilton. I'm moving into there in April, or May, whenever it's ready, which is these studio live-in apartment, like lofts, for artists. And I'll be right there on the main drag. So I never meant to come here. So this is actually a great place to make mistakes.
Yeah.
To learn. Because I really will miss the clientele here, and it's mainly like the nerds. I'm going to miss them so much. I wish they would, like, I want there to be some sort of draw for them to come to Hamilton and visit me, but I'll miss some of the mall walkers.
Yeah.
Not the creepy ones.
Yeah.
And not the creepy boys who come in here, but.
The creepy boys with video cameras.
Yeah. No, I don't know.
Well, I'm in the process of opening a new location and hopefully a couple more things in the works. So. Hopefully I'll have something to fall back on until I can move this location. I would definitely not close down. I would move somewhere else because I've built up this business over the last 5 years and I'm not just gonna shut it down. I've already had to move twice, so it'll just be another move.
All right, well, I think that covers it.
Okay.
So thank you very much.
Cool.
Smasher McDanger.
Hey.
Baby. Behind the scenes. You get us, baby.
There is really cheesy Christmas music inside the mall too.
Oh yes.
It off, they know we went. No, they're not letting us into the nightclub.
No. The nerve of this place. Oh, that's the place to be, but we can't be there.
Going up on a Tuesday. Got your girl in the cut and she Tuesday. Yeah. My geodes bring all the girls to the yard, and they're like, they're bigger than yours. They're like, they're bigger than yours. I can teach you, but I'd have to charge.
I guess it's a brownie inside of a cookie. Here we go.
Whoa.
My father always said, Asher, don't limit yourself. So I'll try anything once. Oh my God.
You getting that? You getting that?
That's
it's gooey.
Insane.
It's gooey. Oh, yeah. It's intense.
Thank you, Mr. Lemel.
Oh, wow. That was worth the price of admission right there.
Pick and choose. Everyone smile. I don't know how to, are we just gonna...
Okay.
That
was good.